Hello, everybody, and thank you for taking time today to talk to us about the Money Max account with United Financial Freedom. My name is Heidi Keener, and we are going to be going through today and talking about this incredible program and everything that that it is able to do for clients. Now, hopefully you have seen something about this program and you have a little bit of an idea of what this program is and how it works. If not, we're going to get into a lot of concepts today. But the short of it is that this program will help you to pay off all of your debts in about a third to a half the time with no change to your current standard of living, no refinancing, no consolidation of your current debts. It's really a very incredible program. I've personally been a user of it since 2006. We're going to talk about that in just a little bit. So let's go ahead and jump in here. Now, our story here, and let me just for one second, I want to make sure that I'm removing, I don't know if you guys can see this at the top. All right. So when the company first started, it was in 1997, and John Wyschenko and Skylar Whitman actually started a mortgage company. It was one of the fastest growing companies in the United States for the first 3 years. Now, they were childhood friends, and growing up, they had actually both experienced foreclosures with their childhood homes, and they experienced the pain of that. If you can imagine as a child, having to move out of your town and, making excuses for that, like your dad, got a new job in a different area, or, having a repo, truck pull up and take the cars out of the driveway. And, they experienced what that was like as a child and the stress that debt can cause on a family, on a relationship, and they knew the pain that that can cause. So they decided to go ahead and start this mortgage company. And what they found was that year after year, people would, get their mortgages, they'd come back a few years later, and they were deeper in debt than they had been 3 or 4 years before. They'd refinance their home, they'd roll in credit card debt, motorcycle, all these other things that they had done, vacation that they had taken, and they'd roll it in and they'd get deeper and deeper in debt. And they said, look, this is great for our mortgage industry and great for our business, but it's really not great for these clients. They're just getting deeper and deeper in debt. So in 2002, they went ahead and tried to find a cure for clients. And they began to create a program that would help people rapidly pay off their mortgages. Now, they didn't just get this idea out of thin air. They actually started doing a lot of research. They went overseas and they looked at a program that in 1997 was created in Australia. And they found that Australia homeowners were paying about $100,000 to $150,000 less in interest than what we were doing as Americans. And they said, well, that's pretty good. Let's look at some of those financial principles. They also found a program overseas in the United Kingdom that was developed by Richard Branson. And he had actually partnered with the Bank of Scotland, the Royal Bank of Scotland. And they were marketing something called the One Loan. And at one point, about 25% of all homeowners in England were using this program. And so they said, okay, well, that's actually pretty interesting. Have either one of those companies ever tried to come to the United States? Well, they found out that they had. And what happened was that when those companies tried to come to the United States, it just really didn't take off. It just really wasn't successful. And that was for a number of reasons. The first was that both of those products were actually mortgage products. And it was essentially a first position home equity line of credit. And clients had to, one, have a mortgage, two, have good credit. Three, have some equity in their homes in order to get a home equity line of credit. But they also had to refinance their entire mortgage, which meant there were closing costs. It was at a variable interest rate. And only about half the states in the United States actually approved that. So they just found, that it just didn't really take off. There also was, a lack of technology and product market, penetration. So they said, look, those are great concepts. What if we could take some of those financial principles, but eliminate some of those downsides, like having to refinance and pay the closing costs and the risk of having your mortgage at a variable interest rate? And so they decided to go out and work with some IT people, engineers, mathematicians, and to really come up with a program that would rapidly help people get out of debt. And so in 2004, they launched the first version of the Money Max account, and it won many, many awards, which we're going to get into in a minute. Initially, they were only offering this to their mortgage clients, their existing customers, And they said, look, we actually are having great success here. What if this is something that we actually could take to a broader market? So in 2005 and 6, they did what we called the Denver beta test. And they got about 400 homeowners in Denver, Colorado to get on this program. And after about a year on the program, what they found was that the majority of them were about 20% ahead of their payoff projection. So if we projected that someone would take a 30-year mortgage and pay it off in 10 years, they actually were around the 8-year mark. So they were finding great success. And they said, look, we've got something here. Let's go ahead and take this to a much broader market. And in 2006, they launched a company called You First Financial. That's actually when I joined the company and when I started using the program myself. Now, we help tens of thousands of people pay off mortgages in about a third to a half the time. At one point, it was actually every 12 minutes that a homeowner was starting their journey to financial freedom by getting on the program, which was really incredible. Now, you'll see there it says combined with a home equity line of credit. We did initially, and at that time in 2006, we had to have a home equity line of credit to make the program work. It was not a first position home equity line of credit as a mortgage, but we did have to have a line of credit. Now, we won many, many awards. As I said, we were featured in all sorts of industry magazines, and we were given the Ernst & Young Entrepreneur of the Year Award in 2008, which is a very big deal. And this was for the financial services division. Now, Ernst & Young doesn't just look at a product and say, you know, hey, that's a nice idea. Let's give these people an award. They actually do very intensive due diligence. They look at the financials of a company. They look at the longevity potential of the company, customer retention, the product viability, and really the impact that it's having on consumers. So there's a whole host of things that they look at. Some of the companies in the past that have got those awards are things like Apple and eBay and Microsoft. I mean, they're very big named companies, but all those companies had to start somewhere, right? And that's kind of where we are. We fully anticipate and have been told by many different industry experts that they see our company going in that direction. We're very proud of that award. Now, continuing on that, some things happened in 2009 that we just didn't expect. We had the global financial meltdown. Many of you probably remember when, you know, Lehman Brothers and AIG and all of these companies were just going under one after another. The stock market was dropping, you know, 500, 800 points in a day. And during that time, we never stopped servicing clients, but clients weren't able to get home equity lines of credit anymore. So the clients that we had that were on the program were generally still able to use it. But new clients to solicit for new business, it just really wasn't an option because the banks stopped lending. It wasn't anything that we actually did. However, John and Skylar, again, just they're so passionate for people and for helping people get out of debt, that they continued to improve the software and to service all of the clients, even though there was no new business coming in. They went back to the drawing board and they said, how can we find a way to eliminate the reliance on a line of credit? And they took several years to actually retool the program and figure out how to launch it again. And they launched under a new name, You Financial Freedom, and tried to figure out, and it successfully did, how to make this program work without a line of credit. Now, that was huge because now we not only can help people without a home, but we can help people without bad credit or with bad credit, with no equity, with no homes. All right. It really opened the entire market. So even people who may just have student loan debt, that's somebody that we're able to now help with this program, which is incredible. We spent nearly $20 million on the software, and over 70,000 clients across the United States have purchased the program. And we have over $2 billion, that's billion with a B, of debt paid down. And that's just principal paid down. That doesn't even count the interest saved. And you can see there the numbers are actually updated as of today. I was up a little early, 6 a.m., but over $2 billion of debt. Now, before we get into exactly how the program works, I want to talk a little bit more specifically about some of the financial principles first and about how interest works. So if you've ever gone into, you know, a major city anywhere in North America, you'll see, you know, that the bank's name is on top of that building, the largest buildings that we have. Banks know how to build an empire. One of the strategies that banks have used for many years is that they know how to pay interest to make interest. And let's look at how that works. Banks have multiple ways of collecting capital. Some of the main ways allow them to pay less than 3%. Sometimes they pay all the way down to 0% interest on the money that they control. But on the flip side, banks tend to earn interest through multiple vehicles, and they can earn it at greater than 6% interest and sometimes all the way up to 20%. Now, where can banks get money at less than 3%? Well, unfortunately, it's off of you. Your checking, your savings, your CDs. Now, where can they actually earn more than 6%? Well, unfortunately, that's on you too, when they loan you money on credit cards and mortgages. The difference between what we earn in interest and what we pay in interest is something known as arbitrage. And banks are really good at making arbitrage work for them. What we want to teach you is how to make it work for you. So if we look at this traditional example of a $200,000 mortgage at 6%, you can see the monthly payment there. The very first month that you make that payment, $199 goes to principal and $1,000 goes to interest. A lot. All right. The second month, only a dollar more goes to principal and a dollar less goes to interest. After the first year, you'll see you've paid $14,000 in payments, but only $2,500 has gone to equity. You'll see after 5 years, $72,000 of your payments have gone towards total payments, and only $14,000 has gone toward equity. That means, or towards principal. That means that 81% of all of the payments you have paid have just gone towards interest. Now you'll see here at 10 years, 21 years, 21 years is the depressing point. It's 21 years to pay off half of the original balance that you owed. So if you look at $200,000 initial borrowed principal, it takes 21 years to pay half of it off. After 30 years, we've paid $431,000 for the $200,000 loan, which means we paid $231,000 in interest. That's more paid in interest than for the purchase price of the house. Now, traditional banking will tell us that there's several ways that you can pay your debt off early. You can refinance to a lower interest rate. You can apply additional money to each payment, which a lot of people will do for a few months and then stop. Or you could do a biweekly payment plan. Now, a biweekly payment plan will actually take about 7 years off of your loan. What we want to do is not just take 7 years off of the loan. We want to pay it off in 7 years, the complete inverse of a biweekly. Now, we're able to do this with no refinancing, no change to your standard of living. We're not doing a biweekly or a debt roll down or a reverse mortgage. And it's not a concept or theory. This is proven. We've been doing this since 2004. So we have a 15-year track record now of this program working. Now, the Money Max account will actually guide you to make take the money that you're already making and the money that you're going to continue to earn and have it work for you every single day. Your money is either going to make interest or cancel interest, but it's no longer going to sit stagnant, allowing the bank to get rich at your expense. So what do we have to do to make this program work? Well, there's four required components. First, you have to have debt. Doesn't matter if it's a home equity loan or a mortgage debt or whether it's student loan debt, just some type of debt. You also have to have a checking and savings account. Now, those are at your local bank. You do not need to change banking institutions. They would stay exactly where they're at now. And you also have to have the Money Max account, or as we call it, the MMA software coaching program. Now, there's a fourth component, or fifth component, I guess, as well, that you can have that's optional, and that's something called an advanced line of credit. An advanced line of credit could be something like a home equity line, a personal line, or even a business line of credit. Sometimes even a credit card with as little as a $300 credit limit will work, as long as it has the proper characteristics, and some of those are listed there below. Now, you do not have to have that. The program now will work with just checking, savings, any sort of debt, and our software. But if you are able to get an advanced line of credit, then it will generally take off about an additional 6 months to a year off of your total payoff. But again, it is not required. So let's go ahead and look at this. What we want to talk about today are the four money saving principles that make this program work: interest accumulation, interest float, interest cancellation, and strategic payoff. So let's get into each one of those. If we look at John and Rebecca Jones making $5,000, spending $4,800 a month, and with $200 a month of discretionary income, and they have that mortgage of $200,000, and in this case, they do have a credit card with at least a $300 limit. They actually have a little bit more limit on that, but they don't owe any balance on that credit card. Now, again, you do not have to have a credit card, but it'll make it work a little bit faster, which is what I want to illustrate here. We have a $200,000 mortgage in month one, and you'll notice that John and Rebecca Jones get paid their paycheck of $5,000. When they get their $5,000 paycheck, it gets auto-deposited into their checking account. The software says, you know what, I don't want you to leave your money in checking. Your money that sits in checking is stagnant and it's not doing anything for you. Let's move that $5,000 from checking over to savings, because at least in savings, it's gonna earn something, even if it's not a lot. In the meantime, let's go ahead and try and let the money sit in savings and earn as much interest as it possibly can. And instead, let's go ahead and charge all of your expenses that you're able to on your credit card. So in this case, rather than writing checks and paying bills, we would go ahead and charge things on the credit card, your mortgage, your car payment, any sort of things that you can. And just to make it easy for illustration purposes, let's say that John and Rebecca Jones are able to charge their entire $4,800 of expenses on their credit card. Now, that's probably not realistic, and that's fine. When you look at your actual analysis, you'll be able to see how it'll work for you. But for ease of illustration, we're just going to say $4,800 of expenses. So they charge everything on the credit card. Now, you'll notice a few other numbers changed, and let's talk about why. The $200,000 mortgage is now $199,801. And the reason for that is because we made our first mortgage payment. Our mortgage payment of $1,199 was made on that credit card. That's part of that $4,800 of expenses. And so the principal, as you guys remember from a few slides before, when you make your first mortgage payment, the principal gets $199 applied towards it. So that principal balance has now gone down. You'll see that the savings account has actually gone from $5,000 to $5,012. And that's because we earned a little bit of interest. And this is the money saving principle that most of you are aware of, and that is interest accumulation. The more we can have money working for you, even if it's earning a small amount, the better than sitting at the bank either doing nothing or letting the bank earn interest off of your money. All right, so that's interest accumulation, the first financial principle. Now, at this point, we're at the beginning of month two, and so John and Rebecca Jones get their next paycheck, and they deposit $5,000 again into their checking account. And the software says, hey, wait a minute, it doesn't make sense to leave that $5,000 in checking. Also, we have $4,800 balance on our credit card. And many of you have probably done this in the past. If I charge $4,800 on a credit card, and I pay it off at the end of the month, how much interest do I pay? That's right, zero. As long as I pay it off in full, I'm able to float interest. I'm able to borrow Visa's money or MasterCard's money or Amex's money without paying any interest as long as I pay it off in full. That means that while I'm charging these $4,800 of expenses, I'm able to leave my money earning interest and borrow somebody else's. And as long as I pay it off in full at the end of the month, I've paid no interest. So we take our $5,000 paycheck and we take $4,800 of it and pay that credit card down to zero. We've now paid zero in interest on that credit card. We have $200 left in checking. Now the software says, all right, time to start working to get you out of debt. Let's take $3,789 out of savings and put it in checking. You'll see the respective balances there. Now notice it did not drain your savings account. The software is always going to make sure that you have some sort of an emergency reserve limit that you will always have in checking and savings. And you actually determine those limits and we'll help to set those up with you. So in this case, they still have at least $1,000 in checking, actually earn savings, a little bit more than that. And they have $3,989 in checking. And the software says, all right, I want you to do what's called a funds transfer. Funds transfers are going to happen every 2 to 6 months, and it's where the software tells you to take money and make an additional payment to principal. So in this case, it says take $3,989 out of checking and make an additional payment to your mortgage. Pay that principal down. And that's the third principle, financial principle, called interest cancellation. So let's look at what that looks like. With interest cancellation, initially we had a $200,000 mortgage. We're 2 months in, right? We made a normal mortgage payment, and then we also sent an extra payment to principal. So our current balance, when we send that $39.89 over to principal, it makes our current balance of our mortgage $195,812. Now the interest rate doesn't change when we do that, and neither does the monthly payment. Those will stay the same. But now we're only 2 months in, and rather than having 358 more payments, we actually only have 340 more payments. We have knocked off 18 payments to the loan. Originally, we were going to pay $231,000 in interest, and now we only pay $212,000. So we have now saved $19,000 by doing one funds transfer. So understand, John and Rebecca Jones have $200 a month of discretionary income. We're only 2 months into the program, which means if they were trying to do this on their own, at most they would have sent $200 to principal the first month and $200 the second month. But by using the financial principles of interest accumulation, interest float, and interest cancellation, we were able to strategically leverage their money and make one funds transfer and save $19,000 of debt, or $19,000 of interest, all right? That's substantial. Now again, that's just one transfer. You're gonna do these every 2 to 6 months. So let's look at the fourth principle, which is strategic payoff. Now, how would you pay this off? Well, there's only one way to pay it off. If you have a $200,000 mortgage, you pay the mortgage down as quickly as you can. But if you have a student loan, you could either start by paying the student loans down first, or you could pay the mortgage down first, right? And then you pay the other one off. So there's kind of two different orders in which we could pay this off. If you have three, well, now we have six different ways we could pay it off. We could start with one, go to another. You know, there's a variety of different options. As we increase more debts, there becomes more options and orders in which we can pay these debts off. But only one is the fastest, only one. What the program looks at, the fourth money saving principle, is the strategic payoff. It's going to look at the amount that you owe on each of the debts, the length of the debt, the interest rate, the calculation of payment. What's really interesting about that, and we don't have time to get into it today, is that some debts are paid with simple interest and others are compound interest. So it may be better to pay off a 6% or versus a 10%. And people say, well, usually it makes sense to pay off a higher interest rate. Yeah, but if it's 6%, you know, simple or compound versus 10% simple or compound, those are very different things. So the software looks at a variety of different factors and figures out what the fastest way is to get to zero. It also looks at whether rates are variable or adjusting. There's a lot of different things that we can't take into account that the program does. Now, John and Rebecca Jones, if they continue to do this program, they have a $200,000 balance in both scenarios, whether they do what the program that we're recommending on the right, the Money Max account, or they don't. On the left-hand side, though, you'll see that they have 30 years to pay off, and on the right-hand side, it's only 15.6, half the amount of time. Instead of paying $247,000 in interest, they're going to pay only $125,000 in interest, which means that we save them about $122,000. What would you do with that money? Work a different job, retire earlier, take more vacations. So much more money that could be in your pocket rather than being in the bank's pocket. What we want to teach you to do is to bank like the bank. The software is going to compute the optimal time to leverage money to pay off your debts and to cancel interest. It sounds like a very easy thing, but as I said, it's actually a 26-page formula of millions of lines of code of algorithms trying to figure out the very fastest way to zero. Banks have done this for many, many years, and now it's your turn to bank like a bank. We call our program a financial GPS. And the reason we do that is because just like a GPS system, it's going to try and figure out, and it will figure out, the fastest way to get to zero. It recalibrates constantly depending upon things that happen in your financial situation. For example, it looks at your income. Do you have multiple streams of income? Are you paid weekly, biweekly, monthly? Are some of the months better than others? Are you commission-based? If you are, we might need to be a little bit more conservative. It's also going to look at the amount that you owe and the terms term of each of these debts, how the minimum payments are calculated, when they're due. It looks at all of these variety of different parts of information using advanced banking strategies, and it calculates mathematically the absolute fastest way to zero. Every time something changes in your life, it will constantly recalculate and change and give you the fastest path to get to zero given the current information. So it's dynamic in a way that nothing else on the market is. Again, what it will do is help you to pay off your debts, make educated financial decisions, because in real time, you'll see whether it was smart to refinance or not, whether it might make sense to buy a rental property, whether you should take a different job. You're able to run a variety of scenarios through the software, and it'll give you the best, most educated decision. You're able to stay focused and track your success. And then, of course, build wealth, which we don't have time to get into today, but that's a huge aspect. Our actual company motto and mission statement is that we want to help you to pay off your debt and build wealth. Convert your debt to wealth. And that's a whole other presentation that, again, we don't have time for today. What the Money Max account does is first kind of understand what it doesn't do. It doesn't move your money or pay your bills. There are no account numbers needed, and we do not have any access to your money. We have no control over it. It stays at your bank, and you are in full control. What we do need to know is what you make and what you spend. And so it's just like an account register where once a month, you're going to get on for about 10 minutes, and you're going to tell it what you made and what you spent for the month. It's very, very easy to update, and it's going to help to keep you completely on track financially. Now, we will help you to eliminate all your debt in as little as 5 to 7 years. We're going to help you to make educated financial decisions. One of the great benefits and side products or byproducts, I guess, to our program is it'll actually help you improve your credit score, because as you start to pay down debt, your debt to income ratio improves, and that'll actually improve your credit score as a byproduct. The software is yours for life. You can take it from property to property. If you don't have a home now and in the future you do get one, that's great. You will be able to use this for many, many years to come. It is not a one-time, purchase for this particular house. You're able to use it from multiple places. There are no mandatory monthly fees or any contract surprises. If you want, there is one option that you can add on an extra feature for a monthly fee of $15 to $20 a month, I believe. And that's an option that you can do. But other than that, you can choose not to do that. And there are no monthly fees ever. Again, no surprises. And the program is yours for life. You also have lifetime customer support and coaching. We'll help you to get set up on the program. Anytime that you have questions, you'll reach a live person based in the United States, and they'll be able to answer any questions with no additional fees to you. So the program is really incredible. What I would say in closing is it works. Okay. We have tens of thousands of clients that have been using this program over the past 15 years. Many of them are already debt-free. We have an A+ rating with the Better Business Bureau. We've won numerous awards and accolades. We offer a money-back guarantee because we are absolutely confident that the program will work. Remember, most of our clients are actually 20% ahead of what we guarantee them. It works, all right? Look, you have to pay back your principal. The money that you borrowed, you have to pay it back. But you get to determine how much interest you're going to pay. So what I would recommend is that you get with the person that sent you this video, that you get your free savings analysis run, and you see the exact month and year that you'll be debt-free. Thank you guys for joining us today. We hope that was informational to you, and we appreciate your time.